song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Be
welcome each of you here for this very special and very unusual occasion in the lives of Dane and Natalie and their families. You know, in all seriousness, a wedding is part of God's grand design for life. Dane and Natalie, as you take this important step, I want you to remember the Bible teaches that marriage was created by God for man's benefit and his blessing. He made a helpmate for Adam and called her woman. In the Old Testament, Moses gave divine sanction to marriage as a legal institution. In the New Testament, the book of Hebrews says that marriage is most honorable among all things. Because God has put his blessing upon this institution, we must approach it with that same sense of significance. So as we begin this afternoon, I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man? I ask you to join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, as we gather today, we ask your blessing on this time, that the memories we make today, Father, would last well into the years ahead. We remember the sacredness of this time and the joy we have as we spend this time together. We pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 31. For this cause a man shall leave his father and mother and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This text of scripture speaks to the oneness that you two will have after this ceremony. The admonition to you, Natalie and Dane, is to leave and to cleave. As you establish your new family, I want you to consider three matters that I think are very significant as you take your vows. First of all, I challenge you to be one in your commitment to God. You won't make it together for a lifetime unless you're both committed to a like faith in Jesus Christ. While many today reject that premise, marriage is a creation of our Heavenly Father. And as such, it's also a spiritual relationship. Your ultimate priority must be your personal commitment to your walk with Jesus Christ. Secondly, I want you to be one in your commitment to each other. The Bible makes it clear that your commitment should be to willfully, sacrificially, and unconditionally accept and love each other. This type of commitment isn't something that many folks are willing to make today. And for that reason, the blessing of marriage is something that many fail to experience. This commitment to each other is absolutely essential for your marriage and your success. And third, I strongly urge you to be one in your commitment to your future. Your future does not belong to you alone, but also to your children, to your extended families. It also belongs to Jesus Christ, who gave your life so that you might enjoy the blessings of a relationship with God. I encourage you to allow him to lead you through the days of your lives together. Make it a priority to seek out his leadership faithfully and live it out. And as you commit yourself to follow his will, you will find a blessing that he intended for you to experience together. Now, Dan and Natalie, if you're ready to confirm your vows into each other, please turn toward each other. Get as close as you can. Dan, check it out. Yes, check it out. Dan, I would ask you to repeat these words after me if they're desired of your heart. I, Dan.
Take thee, Natalie.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
And I pledge to you my faithfulness.
And
there is more, as you might guess. Dave, you promise to be the only family member to run for the essential products, not taking any of the other family members, no matter how many times these seven folks beg to escape the quarantine.
I promise.
Did y'all hear that?
Okay.
You promise to continue to hunt and fish, filling the outside fridge just in case they close down Walmart or the dollar store.
I will start this evening.
You promise as a husband, father, and teacher to help Natalie children with their homework, knowing full well that she doesn't understand Common Core or how to work with Power School.
I promise.
Now, Natalie, would you please repeat these words after me if they're a desire of your heart? I, Natalie.
I, Natalie.
Take thee, Dane.
Take thee, Dane.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
And I pledge to you my faithfulness.
And I pledge to you my faithfulness.
And as we continue, Natalie, if you promise to wash your hands for a full 20 seconds using the proper technique.
I'm an expert. 20 seconds, you got it.
Do you promise to wear the appropriate personal protective equipment while working as an essential employee during the pandemic to keep your family safe from COVID-19?
N95 gloves, wash the hands, we're good. I promise.
You promise to allow Dane to continue hunting and fishing for the continuance of his mental health and sanity.
Absolutely.
And you're sure?
Awesome.
All right. Each of you have rings and intended to be a visible and public sign of the commitments you are making to each other today. Dane, if you'll place the ring on Natalie's hand and hold it there. I ask you, Dane, do you give this ring to Natalie as a token of your love for her?
I do.
Natalie, if you do the same and place the ring on Dane's hand and hold it there. That's not a sign, okay. Okay, you got it. Do you give this ring to Dane as a token of your love for him?
Yes.
These rings symbolize your commitment to one another. I encourage you to wear them proudly and wear them with honor. They are given and received willingly in the name of Jesus Christ, and as such they will become a precious reminder of this special day. Please join me as we pray. Heavenly Father, we stand before you today, affirming your wisdom and grace through the ceremony of marriage. As we laugh and enjoy the laughter, Father, help us remember this is a gift from you to bless our lives, to give us the joy that you intended. We pray that what has taken place today here will bring honor to you and a blessing to Dane, Natalie, their families, and their friends. And as they have spoken their words of commitment to each other, impress upon them the sacredness of the marriage covenant. Help them to honor you in their individual lives and in the home in which they have now established. Crown their marriage with your grace, your love, and now as long as they both shall live. And we pray this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Well, we made it. We weren't sure last night how this would go, but now we know, don't we? Despite all the craziness of these weeks and these masks drive me crazy. Today, your plans are fulfilled. Lord willing, we'll finish the rest of the celebration in the near future. So, by the authority given to me by the state of Kentucky and as an ordained minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Then you may now bump elbows with your bride. Awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to be the first to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Dane Gregory.
Hey! Oh!